My name is Ariel Tolfrey Williams, and I am the Neighborhood Services Program Coordinator here for the City of Monrovia, and I want to welcome everyone to the 10th Annual MAP Neighborhood Conference. I hope you're all enjoying your delicious coffee and this morning and the breakfast. Our theme this morning is Not Without You. This theme was based on our recognition of all the programs and special events and everything that we do as the city. None of this would happen without any of you. We're so proud of all of our MAP leaders, that's everyone wearing the green shirts, because ultimately in the community we couldn't do any of this without you. So, before we get started, I do want to welcome a few people. We do have our City Council joining us today. We have Mayor Pro Tem Becky Shevlin. I don't know where she is, but I saw her walking. There she is. Good morning. We have Mayor Tom Adams. Also don't know where he is, but there we go. And Councilman Larry Spicer is with us as well today. We also have some commissioners I want to make sure to say hello to. We've got Gary Sheffield. I was gonna say somewhere, so there he is. Okay, and we have Commissioner Gina Mills, also saw her. There she is. And my hair twin, Keisha Bowen, also is here today. Okay, so now we are going to go ahead and bring up Councilman Larry Spicer, and we are going to do the Pledge of Allegiance. Oh, the flag salute. I'm sorry, I was talking about the wrong thing. I don't know how to do
it. Hey, please stand and join me in the flag salute, please. Ready, begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilman. Okay, now I'm going to bring up Second Baptist Church incoming pastor, Pastor Chris Bourne. He's going to do the invocation for us.
Good morning. All right, would you just take a moment and bow your head with me as we ask God's blessings on our time today? Our Father and our God, how gracious you are to us. We thank you for this another day that you have allowed us to see, and we just give you thanks and praise. Thank you for this wonderful community. Thank you for these leaders. Thank you, Father, for this vision of MAP today. We pray and ask your blessings. We pray that we will be informed and educated. We pray that health will take place and healing in hearts and minds and bodies of your people. We just welcome you today. We thank you for all of the leaders and those that are serving. And we just pray your continued blessings, not only on this event, but in our community. We do this in the strong name of Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Boring. Now I am going to bring up Bishop DeLar to do a welcome.
Thank you so much, Ariel. Good morning. I am delighted that you are here, and thanks be unto God that you've chosen campus of Second Baptist Church, this 117-year-old parish, which has accomplished many things over the years in this community. This annual 10th MAP conference celebration is significant indeed. For over the years, over the past 10 years, you've done an awful lot of good things, of which I give God thanksgiving and praise for. Thank you, city leaders, for continuing this, given the vision and the insight of the things that are supposed to be done. Throughout this city, as well as the communities around us, the job is still unfinished. And we need you, we need your love, we need your support, and we need your continuance. Many challenges are facing us, and every one of us are intricate parts of the successful conclusion of it all. The Bible teaches us, whoever has this world goods and sees his brother in need and shuts up his heart from him, how does the love of God abide in him? This is the word of God from John 3:17. It has been said succinctly, coming together is the beginning. Thinking together is unity. Working together is progress. And keeping together is success. Unquote, so say I. So please take advantage of what the conference offers to each of us throughout this session today for our good as well as our growth. It is designed for every ethnic group of the human race. How many of you know there's only one race? Every ethnic group of the human race. So come worship with us at any time on our campus. You've already heard from the incoming under-shepherd of this parish as of May 19th. And so I am sure that he, along with the congregants of this parish church, will welcome you in any worship assembly of this parish. So welcome, and do not leave here without finding out and knowing someone you didn't know before. Have fun and be blessed of God. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you, Bishop. And while he sits down, I want to also say good morning, Miss Betty, Bishop's wife. Okay, now I'm going to introduce Mayor Adams.
Good morning. I'm sorry, I know my hearing's not as good as it used to be, but I said good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you. How many of you know this young lady? Everybody? How many of you know that Ariel was selected as Woman of the Year by the California State Assembly? Come on, you can do better than that. Get some real power in the house. Thank you to Second Baptist for their hospitality. This is really, really lovely. Thank you. And Pastor Bourne, I can't imagine how difficult it might have been to pray knowing the bishop's in the house, but you did a great job. And Bishop, you will be missed. You've got quite a legacy here. Monrovia is a better place because you've been here all these years. Thank you. No, it's okay. But I do have one complaint, and it's about Larry. I asked Larry on Tuesday night, I said, Larry, what are they serving for breakfast? And Larry said, it's gonna be a nice country breakfast. And so I didn't have anything this morning, and I came in and they had bananas and strawberries, and I thought, I don't know what country that's from, but shame on you, Larry Spicer. So today's a great day, isn't it? It's a lovely day out there, but it's a better day to be in here, and the things that you're going to learn and participate in help make Monrovia a better place, and for that I thank you all. Because if you look back over the years, Monrovia's improved so much after MAP came into being. And for all of the MAP leaders, would you stand up so we can thank you all? And I thank you because you make our job so much easier. It's really, really a pleasure to serve as a member of your city council. I know Larry feels the same way. I know Becky feels the same way. Monrovia is just such a special place and it just keeps getting better. So I thank you for all that you do. Congratulations again to Ariel. Go ahead and give her another hand. Now, I thought Ashton was supposed to be here. Is Ashton here? Not yet? So if you see Ashton Gow, how many of you know Ashton from the city clerk's office? If you see her Ashton was just awarded the Certified Municipal City Clerk's title. She worked really hard to get that. We're one of the few cities of our size that has two Certified Municipal City Clerks, so say congratulations to Ashton and Ariel. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Tom. Okay, I'm going to go over some instructions for the rest of the day. In about 7 minutes, we're going to start going to our first session. Please check your conference schedule so you know where your classroom is. Your second session also starts at 11:30. Just so you know, all classes are going to be upstairs. You can either go out this door to your right to go upstairs, or you can go this door to your left to go upstairs. Also, if you are in need, there is an elevator out towards your left. So if you are in need of using an elevator, you have that option to your left. Okay, so quick note, for the Healthy Eating Made Easy class, if you signed up for it, you're good to go to your class. If you did not sign up for it, that class is full. Just want to let you guys know now, there's only so much room in the room, and that class is full. But if you signed up, you're good. Just go to your class. If you did not sign up, I'm sorry, that class is full. Okay, so to the important stuff, the lunch, which is the unhealthy portion of the show, that is at 12:30. We're going to be having Tommy cheeseburgers. We're going to have Wendy's chicken sandwiches. Athens will be barbecuing hot dogs and hot links, and there will also be sandwiches from Jersey Mike's. So I promise we will feed you later today. Okay, so one more thing. Lunch starts at 12:30. Don't come down here before that. Ask your speakers tons of questions. Everyone has prepared very hard for this, and they want to talk to you. So make sure to ask them a bunch of questions, and don't come down here until 12:30. So, one more thing before we go. I want to take a really nice picture of everyone from where you're sitting. Please make sure to smile, and I promise I will get it on my phone, okay? So make sure you can smile and make sure you can see me, and then I will get you in here, okay? Let me get to the right thing. I was unprepared, okay. Okay, is everybody ready? Yes. I don't see everybody smiling, so I'm just gonna wait until we all smile. Everyone smiling? Yes? Okay, don't make me call you by name. Okay. If I make it a selfie, it's only gonna be at me, so I can't get myself in it. Okay, ready? Okay, I'm gonna panoramic, so smile. Make sure you're smiling really hard. I see some people not smiling. Thank you for waving in the back. Smile, smile, smile. All right, beautiful. And then thank you for the hand signals on the other side. Thank you, I appreciate that. I appreciate everyone. Okay, so, you can go enjoy your classes. Again, you can go that way, you can go that way. Every classroom is labeled, so you guys know where you guys are gonna go. Every classroom is labeled. See you later.
So I developed a program, it's called the 8 Qualities of Great Leaders, and I teach to these 8 things. So they asked me to teach something a little different than I normally do. Normally I teach the Legendary Leadership Academy, the 8 Qualities of Great Leaders. For this conference, I'm going to talk about all of their senses of purpose. Where I'd normally talk about Mother Teresa for attitude, I'm going to talk about her purposefulness as a human being. So, two things you got to remember. I teach leadership, and the two easiest things to remember about leadership is you're put on earth to influence others in a positive way. And influence is like your example. You're put on earth to be an example.
That's called neighborhood compatibility, and the ordinance that Monrovia adopted went into effect 2.5 years ago. And what it looks at, and we're going to give you some good pictures today to kind of guide you through that, is good site planning, building form, neighbor impact review. I'm going to talk about neighborhood treasures today, and it is part of the Monrovia Area Partnership Program, and it's also part of Art in Public Places.
Unfortunately, I lied to you a little bit because there's a lot more than 10 top secret resources. So, just by show of hands, how many of you live in Monrovia?
What are we going to talk about? The definition of an active shooter, characteristics, an early warning sign, scenario and timeline of events, active shooter incident statistics, law enforcement action during an active shooter. That's some early warning signs that come up. Okay, if you see something, say something.
So let's take a look. What is Dementia-Friendly America? So this was their proving ground. Minnesota started one city. Now as you can see, the entire state of Minnesota is dementia-friendly.
We can really help make this community more respectful, safer, and you know, really be a place where we support one another.
Sandwich and a cappuccino is what our team decided for what was going to be served for lunch. I'm not sure we're having a cappuccino later. We have sandwiches. That would cost an additional 11 cents on the bill. If you go buy $50 worth of household goods, that would increase 38 cents on the bill. And if you buy $50 worth of groceries, there's no increase because groceries are not prepared, so they're exempt from sales tax.
The African Methodist Episcopal Zion Church, the origins of this church date to the John Street Methodist Episcopal Church in New York City. Black members left this church in 1796 due to racial discrimination. This is Myrtle Avenue, 1887. You will notice the elaborate improvements,
What we were able to do is capitalize on specially trained officers so we can have a number of officers and a number of equipment that are needed in case something happens.
But prostate cancer, like I said, if you catch it early, it's 100% curable. So it's not to be scared, it's just meant to be smart about it. Yeah.
Will you do it on people under 40?
Yeah, Flora wants to do it.
But you got to be compassionate to their family because they're dealing with this 20%. You think they want to call you and come out here and, you know, in their minds, what they see in the news, oh, no, they're going to end up hurting my kid or something, you know, because they don't know him or she like I am. So I try to educate them in that too, like, hey, have some compassion, take some time.
So you get to say to yourself, I'm Officer Scott with the Monrovia Police Department, and you see a lady on the screen. She's going to be walking towards you. Whenever you see the lady on the screen, you can start communicating with her, okay?
So having trees is important to our overall ecosystem. But there was a way that you can actually water a tree more efficiently. And so we worked with our team to put together some simple information that this would be a good DIY project that folks could do at home. But if you're looking to do some new landscaping in your yard, or if you know somebody who's doing new landscape and you want to direct them, this is a free workshop.
Thank you.
keynote speaker. His name is Mike Pointer, and I will let him take it from here.
All right, so City of Monrovia, good afternoon to you. I don't have a lot of time to talk about myself. You can always go to mikepointer.com to see about me. But here's what I'm here to do. City of Monrovia invited me to talk about the relations, your neighborhood relations, how to become a stronger community. So I have some really important key points that I want to share with you. Now, I tend to move around a bit, and I'll be on the floor. I don't like hiding behind podiums. When my mentors taught me, they said, don't hide behind the podium. Like, and I like to move anyway. Okay, but now first, I have your absolute attention. We're gonna do a little bit of audience participation because I need to make sure that you actually hear me, that you are not just listening, right? Or excuse me, not just hearing me, but that you're actually listening. So we're gonna play a game called, Do You Listen As Well As You Hear? Now this is audience participation. I'm so thankful that you don't have the eating ware that makes noise, right? This is great, right? Just what I wanted. But I gotta move because I have a hard out back to LA to teach a class. Right, so I have to move here. So here's what I want to do. Okay, so do you listen as well as you hear? Okay, let's play a little game. Y'all help me now. How do you spell hop?
H-O-P.
H-O-P, sounds good. I think I learned that in second grade. Hop, H-O-P. This is to make sure that you actually hear me. Okay, H-O-P. Now, what should you do when you get to a green light?
Go!
No, you go. You actually go. So, do you listen as well as you hear? Okay, wait, one more. Okay, so how do you spell silk? I think I learned that in the third grade. Okay, great. Silk, S-I-L-K. Okay, sounds good to me. But what do cows drink?
Water.
Yeah, they drink water. Do you listen as well as you hear? I know you're, okay, wait. So we gotta make sure we're on track before my big, deep lesson. Okay, so, all right, how many months in the year have 28 days in them?
All of them.
Yeah, see? Ah, we're getting better, great. Man, the moment you say February. Okay, great. All right, so last one. I think we're on track. We're almost ready for the big lesson. Okay, so, how many pairs of animals did Moses take on the ark? No, Moses didn't take them on the ark. Noah did. Do you listen as well as you hear? So you can't just, you gotta pay attention to this. Okay, so let's get to the lesson. So here's what I wanna do. I wanna work on... So one of my titles is that I'm a confidence coach for business executives. I've been working with Akron. Praise God, I'm in my 19th year of business. In fact, that's why I'm in a hurry because I gotta go back to LA. To teach a class, and I just came for one, and praise God I made it over here. The traffic was beautiful coming, and I was looking at the other side, I'm like, oh Lord, help me back to LA, right? The other side of 605 to 10. But now listen, so many people run around talking about how loving they are and how caring they are, and yeah, I just love people, and I love, and then you see on Facebook, you put something on Facebook, they disagree with you, now they don't love you anymore. Now you ain't my friend no more. I can't stand you, right? Missing that. So I wrote a book that kind of terrified some people, and the TED Talk people are afraid of it, right? But it's called Love Is Not the Answer. Now, I know some, and I go to this church, and I'm under the leadership of Bishop William LaRue Delarue, and my new pastor coming in, Chris Bourne, right? Now remember what Grandma taught us, Grandpa too. Don't judge a book by its cover. Remember, right? So what I'm gonna do is break this down. because on page 8 of my book, which I'm going to give you, give away like 4 books, on page 8 of my book, it explains that respect is the answer, love is the goal. Respect is the answer, love is the goal, and love takes work. Any of you that have been married for 10, 15 years, you know that when the honeymoon is over, love is work. Loving your neighbor, I'm not talking about the noun love, I'm talking about the verb love, because it's more of a verb than it is a noun. Love is active, right? So most people aren't ready for that conversation, let alone my book, okay? But I'll give away a few copies. So let's work on, I believe, one of the first values that you learned when you were a child, which is respect. Let's start with respect. Because I don't know if you love people that cut you off on the road. Oh, I love them anyway. Oh, just love them. I don't know, right? So I want to work on a couple of ideas that will help you become more respectful towards your fellow man. And it deals with this crazy thing we call driving here in LA, right? One of the ways we'll access respect of others is through self-control. Self-control, it's a fruit of the spirit. Self-control. Now, most of us have certain hot buttons, right? Things that set us off behind the wheel of the car. And I wrote about it in my first book, because I've authored 4 books, I'm about to start my 5th. I wrote about it in my first book, Programming Your Mind for Success. I had to learn, I said, Lord, help me, help me with self-control, because I wanted to do some dangerous things to someone on the freeway at one time that put me and my baby boy son, my first son, Mike, when he was 6 months, I was near Dodger Stadium, and he literally tried to run me off the road and then did something with his fingers in the, I'm in my church environment, so, but I think you catch my drift, right? And the Lord had to restrain me, because I got my little precious son in the back, and I was in a Volvo, a pretty sturdy car, and I said, and I was so angry, I was terrified of myself, and I said, Lord, help me with my anger. I got a very hot head, Lord, you know I do. Help me, right? So he blessed me with these ideas right here, and I now teach them to my course participants. Number one, right? So we have to exercise self-control. So number one, a driver that flips you off for no reason. This is gonna happen in your community, I'm sure it has. So like, what do you do? What you do is you say, I am in control, right, of my emotions, not other people. I'm in control. So what you wanna do is, and I mean, I taught this to my wife because she used to be on her horn all the time. You know, and now you honk your horn or whatever and somebody will want to shoot you, right? What you honking at me for? It's like that's what the horn is for. So, I mean, you're about to like hit my car, right? But there's no reasoning when you're dealing with, you know, demonic people. I'm in my church, I can say that, right? I'm at my church, this is my church. Yeah, 19 years, I can say that, right? So, what you want to do is learn self-control. I do it through prayer. Right? I don't know what your method is, right? But I do it through prayer. Number one, this really gets under your skin. Drivers that block the street talking from car to car so you can't pass. Right? And like, one time I waited. I was like, let me just see how long they're gonna block the street. And I couldn't go around. They were double parked on a small street. I couldn't go around. So I waited, it was like a minute and a half. And then finally they moved on. And the person that was parked to the curb, they looked at me like, yeah, what you gonna do? And I was like, wow, but the Lord gave me this situation. Pray for something. God will say, okay. You wanna learn how to have more self-control? Okay. And I'm gonna sprinkle some stuff your way this week. And I don't wanna hear any complaints, right? So, drivers that block the street, either, I guess sometime you're just gonna have to wait, or you can wiggle your way out, turn around and go the other way. Not sit and jaw with them and argue with them and be angry with them. This happened, do you know they say behind the wheel, I believe police officers say, law enforcement says more traffic violations are made from individuals that are right around the corner from your house. Like people do California rolls, they run red lights. The reason why is because I'm near home, I feel safe. This is my, you automatically feel safer in your neighborhood, right? Once you're near your house. So some of these things are happening to you in your neighborhood, right? And I mean, who knows? You could see them at Walmart. You could see them at some store. And now what are you gonna do, right? And it's like, oh, that's the whatever you call it, that cut me off. And now you're in line going, all right? Now we're talking about better community relations now. Number three, people that walk on the, now this isn't really in your vehicle, but people that walk on the wrong side of the walkway. You know how when you're walking, you walk like cars passing on the street? You stay on your right, I'll stay on my right. Man, this used to irk me. Because now, what am I supposed to do? Change sides so now someone that's walking on the correct side, you think they're gonna move? No, I'm incorrect. Just stay to your right. Right, and it used to fry my brain, leaving the gym, you know, walking down the sidewalk or whatever. And they won't move. It's as if you're wrong. Right? So I said, Lord, you know, help me. And he says, okay. So I'm gonna send some more people down the wrong side of the sidewalk. Just so you, Mike, for you, so you can work on your self-control, right? Because you're not gonna change their mind. You ever see somebody doing something they're wrong, it's two left feet and they won't bend? They won't bend, they know they're wrong. My wife just said that to some lady that was harassing some people around her mother's place. She said, and the lady was yelling, this and that. And my wife looked at her and she said, you know you are wrong. You know you are wrong. And then she, kind of cleared her up a little, right? Just wrong, it's two left feet. But sometimes the Lord sends a test to you. Number four, people on their cell phone while driving and not paying attention. And you can see in their rearview mirror, you can see when their head's down. Oh, they texted, right? And then you wanna honk your horn, or do something with your fingers or whatever. Self-control, try to get away from them. It's like, can I get away? Because folk carry guns and they shoot. They don't care. Look at the loss of life. Look at it. Folk, they care more about animals, and I love animals, but not over human beings. No, there's all this animal worship is out there. Please don't send me your email. He said he hate animals. No, that's not what I said. I just said that human beings come first. We're the crown of God's creation, not animals. Some of you don't like what I'm saying right now, but I'm known for being provocative. I'm known for getting under people's skin. At least you might say, well, at least he's authentic. At least he tells the truth. And then you'll say, you know what? I can trust him because he's not concerned with whether or not you like him. He wants to be honest. He'll speak his truth. And that's why some of my clients can't stand me, hate my guts and liver. Because when I say I'm a believer, see, they don't like it. How's that? What that got to do with this industry? You know, it's like it has a lot to do with it, right? Number five, a driver that cuts you off. Now, let's work on, this going to instantly help some of you when you leave here today. Okay, listen. So, you hear people say, what's wrong with you? Oh, man, they cut me off. Actually, no one cut you off. Almost every time you say it, no, they didn't. Guess what? Your car, whatever your vehicle was on, it's still on, and you have no incision in your car. When you get out of the car, is there a cut in the side, in the quarter panel? No. Is your car still on the road? Yeah. Well, they didn't cut you anything. All they did was change lanes close to your car and cause some type of psychological, emotional reaction in you. That's all they did. They didn't touch your car. Wait, you know what's funny? People get in car accidents. You think you'd see more people outside of their car fighting after an accident, but they're just as calm. But behind the wheel, when they get close to my car, then they throw fingers and cuss and jaw and yell and the whole thing. But there's no accident. It's amazing, right? You'd think you'd see more people arguing, yelling at each other at the scene of an accident. But you don't. People are just as calm. It's amazing, right? Sometimes it just takes a shift in philosophy. What's the most healthy way to respond to this? Not react, but respond. Listen. So no one cut you anything. Change your language. It can help your nervous system. It can help keep the heat down. Listen, number six, people cross the street during a red light, man, in Hollywood all day long. You ever see people walking on a red light and they just walk, they're not supposed to be walking, it's green for you, and they just be walking. They don't even look now. They don't look, they just walk like this. They don't look, they don't wave, they're just on a, that's why you hear about them getting hit all the time. A pedestrian was killed and a pedestrian was severely injured because they walk on red lights, real slow, won't even acknowledge it, in Hollywood all day long. So the Lord had to work with me on that. I saw a 12-year-old kid do it 2 weeks ago. I wanted to hop out the car, take off my belt. But it's like, no, they'll send me to jail, so I can't do that. 12-year-old kid, he was arrogant about it. He looked at my car and he's like, he's like, what you gonna do, right? And I said, look at the kid. And some hellions gonna mow him down because they don't care about human life. And we'll hear about it on the news because the parents did not teach him. Listen, friends, listen. When you walk into a crosswalk, would you please put your phone down? Why would you have your face buried in your phone in the crosswalk? It's idiotic. No, it is. You can't even see the cars that are coming. Some people mow you down in the crosswalk and they'll keep going. They don't care. And some of you, I'm speaking to you right now. You don't like what I'm saying. You don't like it. I don't like this guy. Why they call him in? Good for you. Might save your life. You might develop some wisdom one day and say, man, that guy was right. That loudmouth pointer guy. He was right. I shouldn't do that. Why? Because I don't like when other people do it. Oh, good. Good. Right? Put your phone down. Go somewhere and stop, right? Then look at your phone. So you can keep yourselves out of harm's way, right? Number seven, this gets me. Selfish people at gyms that won't share their equipment. Because I go 5 days a week, right? And I walked up to one guy and I said, excuse me, how many sets do you have left? He said, 40. And I said, okay, great, thanks. I walk over here, I'll just go do something else, right? So I watched him, right? He had one set left, and then he walked away from it. Oh, and his skin color looked like mine, so it wasn't racism. You can't use that one, ha ha ha. His skin was brown, just like mine. I know America's got you so caught up on this racism thing. Oh, I know I'm getting under some of your skin, but that's what I came to do. Because if you think that's what's stopping you, I've been in business 19 years. The rainbow takes my course. Not just people that have skin that look like mine. If you're hung up on, I can't get around up the head because they're white man and all, I'm getting under some of y'all's skin right now. Because that's your excuse. And it cannot be your excuse. You are the reason you don't succeed. It's your philosophy. It's how you view life. It's because you watch too much television and they govern your thinking. They teach you, they seed you how to think. Listen, I used to gangbang myself back in the day. 1980, Carson Cripps, I share this stuff, serious. 190, just, this kind of thing, right? And the Lord snatched me out of that lifestyle. And now I go to high schools and I teach these youngsters. When you get out of school, don't tear up your 20s and spend your 30s repairing your 20s, right? Listen to your parents. They love you. I know you don't agree with them, but they love you. And they want to see after you. And they know after 18, that's when the kids go up and tear up their lives. Because I'm grown. You can't tell me what to do. Yeah, you sure are, precious little one. And you will destroy your life without the governance and the guidance of a loving parent. You'll destroy yourself. Right? So, I wish I had more time, friends, but listen, when it comes to self-control, when needed, repeat these. Now, this is kind of in my world. In Christendom, we talk a little different, but I have what they call worldly people as part of my program, so I have to speak in terms of like affirmations and stuff like that, right? Just like if you're a math teacher, you teach 2 + 2 = 4, right? Okay, so when you're stressed, right, what you want to do is say to yourself, I'm completely in control of my emotions and situations. Not the situation controls me, but I'm in control of it. I'm in control of how I think, feel, and act. I also will practice now the best possible response to this situation. Like my wife and I say now, like when something crazy is happening or I'm about to just do something stupid, right? And she always says, what's on the other side of your stupidity? What's on the other side of, so when you go do that, man, I ought to go over there. Okay, great. Then what's on the other side of your stupidity, right? Just see it ahead. If I do that, then this is gonna happen. And for men, it's tough. It's tough because you don't like to feel like somebody punking you or bossing you or taking advantage of you, and you want to protect your family. It's tough sometimes to just say, Lord, help me through this. Help me, Lord, I still want to go over there. Right? But I'm in control of the situation, right? But more than that, this is my opportunity to grow. Yep. I ask the Lord, I want to be more patient, I want to be more kind, I want to be more loving. Okay, then situations are going to show up for growth. If you complain about it, then you really don't want to grow. You don't. You want stuff to be easy. I just want people to do what I say. Well, then that's control. You may not have it that way. So friends, listen, better community relations and closing, it starts with you. It starts with you in your community. How you treat people in your own community, not who they voted for. Those are the only people you're nice to, right? Because that's not going to cut it. It doesn't matter who they vote. I don't even care what people believe. I don't care if somebody, man, they racist. I don't care. I don't care what people believe. I don't. Guess what? All I care about is how you treat me. Some of y'all know this from folk in your family. And see, it has nothing to do with love. Right? It's like, yeah, they're my family member. I love them. Hey, when's the last time you talked to them? Well, we don't talk much because they live a different life, but I sure love them. It's like, okay, good, good. All that matters is how we treat each other, right? Not what people believe, right? But what they, because some people vote different. Some people believe in this and believe in that. Hey, I'll treat you with respect. We have a psycho neighbor across the street from us. She claims my wife tries to break in her house. She came to our door with a ball peen hammer one night, 3 a.m. And y'all know my wife. You know, I mean, she saved my life. She pulled me out of some hell I was living when I met her, right? Serious. And y'all know that sweet that woman is. So you know she wouldn't dare. What was she gonna look like breaking in somebody's house, trying to steal their deed to take their house? Like, serious. And this lady go to church. I ain't gonna mention the church, not this one. We have her praise robe on and stuff on Sunday. Serious. But see, we still, to the best of our ability, we treat her with respect. That's all. Even though she has violated my family time and time again, gotten real close to danger. But we just say, Lord, this is our test. A neighbor that won't go away. Keep putting the house up for sale. People come by, she still won't move. And the Lord says, I'll keep that thorn there because I'm trying to grow you. I'm trying to grow you in awareness, kindness, respect, patience. This is my walk. It's not to be an actor. I used to act, and the Lord blessed my wife and I with a ton of commercials, and we're all over TV for a while, and it was great. And then the Lord said, okay, now I want to use you this way. I want to use you over here. Yeah, you are going to be the next Denzel, and all you need is theme music when you move to Hollywood, the whole thing. But I want to move you. I want to use you over here now. And guess what, son, you'll be much more fulfilled if you let me use you this way. Because if I make you the Nick Denzel, right, you'll probably destroy your marriage.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And your children will hate your guts and liver when it's all done. Serious? Because they love their mother. I want them to love their mother. I love the closeness they have. Sometimes we have two cars. And they say, Dad, I'm riding with Mom. I say, I'd ride with Mom too. No, serious. I'm serious. Because she's just fun to hang out with. She's fun to hang out with. Serious. Right? She helped save my life, that's for sure. So I know she's not here, but you know, she'll hear I was saying great things about her. So we got that, and I do have, listen, here's how I'm gonna do this. Here we go. So I have this controversial book here called Love Is Not the Answer, right? I want y'all to read it, right? It's a great book. Give yourselves a hand for being such a great audience and participating. I appreciate you for listening. I have to hightail it back to, God bless my travel, back to LA. I have just a busy schedule all day long, but it's great to be busy, and the Lord has blessed my business and my ability to speak and share and be transparent. I always try to be as transparent as I can when the Lord blesses me to get to stand before humankind and share. One more hand for yourselves, folks. I appreciate your attendance. Man, get your prostate checked up. It's free. It's free. Yes, bless you.
It's raffle time. Everyone have your red tickets? I know my hand's in here, but pretend it's not me. If I don't call your number, don't tell me I should have picked yours. I'm sorry. Oh, we still have more. And the first prize we're going to give is from Monrovia Police Department. They've got a lot of great stuff in there. I told them they had to make a really, really good basket. So hopefully they're still in the room listening to me. They might be outside. Oh, there's In-N-Out gift cards and a whole bunch of other stuff in there. So let's see. The first ticket is 430-512. Did you win? All right. Congratulations, there's candy, there's tickets, or money to In-N-Out. That's a party. Okay, so the next one we're going to call, I'm letting you guys know if someone under the age of 21 wins this one, we're gonna have to skip one because this is wine, or we'll give you another one. But this is a nice thing of wine. There's a lot of wine in there. Okay, so, from Paul Calamacarian. Did I say Paul Calamacarian? Okay, I said it right, thank you. Okay, and it's 430-444. I'm hoping my mom wins that one. No? Okay. 430-444. Going once. Okay, we're gonna go the next ticket for that one. 430-607. Mom didn't win that one either. Wow. Wow. No one? 430-607? You win? All right, come on up, come on up, come on up. Okay, while she does that, we're going to go for the next one. We have a raffle. Okay, it is a nice raffle basket from, I know it was City of Monrovia staff. Is Brittany Mello in here? It's City Manager's Office, I believe. It is a nice picnic basket, including some cool plates, blankets, ooh, and Girl Scout cookies. Okay, 430-336.
Nobody here.
430-336. All right, you heard it. We're going on to the next ticket. 430-720. You win? All right, come on up, come on up. Okay, and the last one that we're doing in here, we are still doing more raffles, but you have to join our information fair outside after we're finished here for it. This is from the Monrovia Historical Museum. It is a book all about Monrovia. It's the Centennial Monrovia. So there you go. Okay. 430-475. 430-475. All right, I'll go to the next one. 430-301. Last three digits. Oh, all right. All right, congratulations. Okay, guys, that's the last raffles for inside. But before we go outside, I just have a couple of quick announcements, and then we're going to move outside, okay? I want to thank you all for coming again. I want to thank all of the instructors. I want to thank the Volunteer Center. I'm almost done. Thank you. Okay, I want to thank the instructors, volunteers, city staff, and our sponsors, the Volunteer Center and Second Baptist, everyone who made this possible. Thank you guys so much. And now I want you guys to go outside to our smaller parking lot right out there. You guys all pass by it on the way in. There are about 30 information booths that are waiting to talk to you. They are city staff, they're different people from the community, different organizations, all ready to talk to you. If you have any questions, you just want to say hello to some people, there's a lot of people already milling around. So make sure you go out there. And if you gave us your event evaluation, you are already entered for more raffles. And we're going to start as soon as I move the sound system over, so. Get ready for that. There's also a lot more hot dogs and hot links, so if you want to grab that on your way out, please feel free to do so. Also, one last thing, we have health screenings. They are free and they are here for you. So please go outside and take advantage of the health screenings. They're inside another building, but there's a big sign and you can't miss it. Thank you guys so much for coming. See you outside.